How many products grow from nearly nothing to $100 billion in sales in under a decade? The iPhone is one of very few and far between examples. But it appears that novel type 2 diabetes and weight management medications, like Wegovy and Ozempic, which can help people lose 15 to 25% of their weight and better manage diabetes, are well on their way to joining these rarefied ranks. They're extremely effective, with few observed side effects. After initial success in treating type 2 diabetes, they've gained popularity for their ability to support weight management as well. With roughly 50% of the U.S. adult population pre-diabetic or diabetic, some estimate that nearly 1 in 10 Americans will use these medications by 2030. That's about 30 million people. And with a current price tag of more than $10,000 per year, that could mean, well, hundreds of billions in revenue for pharma companies. Some are even calling these wonder drugs, and more potential use cases are being explored, such as for addiction management and even for Alzheimer's. So let's unpack this phenomenon in three parts: the underlying mechanism of action, the types of drugs available, and the concerns surrounding their use. First, the mechanism. These drugs work by mimicking the role played by specific gut hormones. Hormones create bodily responses by binding to specific associated hormone protein receptors. So these drugs mimic hormones by binding directly to protein receptors. This activates the receptor just as if the hormone had been there and triggers the same bodily responses. Activating is also called agonizing, and these drugs are called agonists accordingly. There are two particular hormones in question here. One is the GLP-1 hormone. Binding to its protein receptor triggers a range of metabolic reactions. For one, the secretion of the hormone insulin, which works to reduce blood sugar. More insulin, less blood sugar. It also inhibits the secretion of another hormone, glucagon. Glucagon is a bit like the opposite of insulin. It works to increase blood sugar levels. So, less glucagon, less blood sugar. Importantly, GLP-1 receptor activation also triggers a change in signals to and from the brain, significantly reducing feelings of hunger. Lastly, it slows the process of moving food through the stomach, called gastric emptying. The second hormone is GIP. Binding to the GIP receptor has a more narrow set of effects, primarily the increased secretion of insulin. It doesn't have the same demonstrable and consistent impact on glucagon or feelings of hunger. While drugs targeting these hormones are not entirely new, recent enhancements have led to a novel set of drugs that are longer lasting and more effective. So let's turn to the different types of these novel drugs. There are two types, or classes, defined by the hormones they mimic. One class of drugs binds to and activates the GLP-1 hormone receptor. These are called GLP-1 agonists accordingly. The most effective GLP-1 agonist is semaglutide, produced by Novo Nordisk. It's sold under three brands, depending on the indication, the use case, the formulation, say oral versus injectable, and the dosage. Ozempic is the injectable form, approved for use in diabetes in 2017. More recently, it was approved for weight loss as well. Wegovy is a higher-dose injectable form, used primarily for weight loss. Rybelsus is the pill form, used primarily for diabetes. The second type of drug takes a dual approach, binding to both the GLP-1 and GIP hormone receptors, GLP-1 GIP agonists. This is a newer development, and packs a bit more punch. By activating both GLP-1 and GIP receptors, these medications offer better control over blood sugar and more significant weight loss. The first company to commercialize GLP-1 GIP agonists was Eli Lilly with Tirzepatide. Tirzepatide is an injectable. When used for diabetes, it's called Mounjaro. When used primarily for weight loss, it's called Zepbound. Tirzepatide is a bit more expensive than semaglutide, and since it's newer, slightly less is known about its longer-term effects. Let's turn to the concerns surrounding these medications. For one, side effects. Proven short-term side effects remain largely minor, like nausea and vomiting, but longer-term impacts have been less well studied. Another concern, cost. Without insurance coverage, these are prohibitively expensive, up to $1,000 a month. And costs will likely not drop soon. Semaglutide and tirzepatide are patent-protected in most major regions until the 2030s. Plus, health insurance companies and employers who sponsor employee health plans and can set coverage terms are tightening their policies due to the high costs. Some employers that self-insure have declined to cover the medications, and others have increased the body mass index threshold for coverage. High costs and declining coverage may make these drugs affordable only to the wealthiest patients, leaving the rest to manage their diabetes or obesity with less effective options. A second concern emerges from this very problem: the rise of non-approved and potentially unsafe alternatives, sometimes referred to as DIY peptides. These products are typically compounded at pharmacies and pose a greater risk of contamination and dosing errors, as they don't undergo the same review for safety, effectiveness, or quality. Lastly, some worry a focus on drugs will reduce the attention on other weight loss solutions, like diet and exercise.